Oh. ordered me to discuss about his life history. Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, he was disciple of Srila Rupa Goswami Pad. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, he have heard from Gurudev, which he has written in his literature. Jiva Goswami published it by his own hand, handwriting. There is no tape recorder, no machine, no dictaphone, nothing. Everything have to by handwriting. So once, when Jiva Goswami was young,
and was also nephew of,
not only disciple, nephew of Srila Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami.
Also blood related.
It's blood relation.
This world and that
transcendental world. So, when he was young, he used to serve Rupa Goswami, and Rupa Goswami has ordered him to correct his literature. So now it can come in our mind, the Rupa Goswami Pad in one hand, eternal associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Mahaprabhu's Roop, and other hand, eternal associates of divine couple as Rukmanjari. Is there any fault in the literature? How is this possible? And why Rupa Goswami Pad ordered him to correct his literature? How we can reconcile this? Srila Rupa Goswami, when he used to write, he absorbed in his mood. Then he forget that his grammatical is correct or not. So, Jiva Goswami will correct that grammatical thing, not his mood. So, when he was writing
about Guru Bhakti, Guru Nishtha in him,
it is called Jiva Goswami. So,
first is Guru Nishtha.
So, Guru Nishtha is the backbone of bhajan. So, Jiva Goswami taught us in his life history. So, once Rupa Goswami was writing Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, the meantime, one very learned scholar of India named Vallabhacharya came to Rupa Goswami, and he was older than Rupa Goswami because he made
he
it
was older also than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Yes, he is even older than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he took Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his birthplace near Prayag, Arail Gram, and Rupa Goswami also there with Mahaprabhu at that time. So when he came to Vrindavan and during darshan, he met with Rupa Goswami and told Rupa, what are you writing at the now at present time? I want to correct your literature. Rupa Goswami is the embodiment of humility. Or yes, it's my good fortune. So after that, he went to Jamuna for taking bath. Jiva Goswami, he was so much nishtha of his Gurudev, he could not tolerate this thing. What? He want to correct my Gurudev's literature? What kind of human being is this? He could not tolerate this. So he make a trick. Oh, there is no water, I have to go to bring water from Jamuna. In this pretense, he took a water pitcher and went to Jamuna. And he asked, he paid respect to him and asked, oh, you want to correct my Gurudev's literature?
Oh Prabhu,
you told that you want to correct Srila Rupa Goswami's literature, what fault you have seen there? Then you want to correct that thing? Then Vallabhacharya told, yes, I have seen in his literature, bhukti mukti spriha javat pisati iri vartate tavat bhakti sukha sattva kathamadbu dayo bhave. Meaning of this shloka, the desire of bhukti and desire of mukti means, bhukti means to enjoy and mukti means liberation. When these two desires will be heart of a sadhak, then bhakti devi never manifests in sadhak's heart. So Vallabhacharya told, he compare bhakti and mukti like a witch. How is possible? Jiva Goswami humbly replied, no, no, is not compare bhakti and mukti with a witch. The desire of bhakti and desire of mukti, this like a witch. If the desire of bhakti and mukti means liberation and to enjoy this desire in our heart, then bhakti that will be far away from our heart. So the desire of bhakti and mukti like a witch, they can swallow us completely.
Why not
bhakti and mukti? Not why Guru Goswami not compare bhakti and mukti like a witch? Because bhakti and mukti, they are not witch. Why not?
You are in Srimad Bhagavatam so many times.
So if someone receives bhakti, bhakti manifests somebody's heart, being causeless, merciful, then bhakti is the sthiratara bhagavat jadishat daivena phalati dibya kishora murti mukti saram mukulitanjali sevati asman dharmartha kama gatayo samaya pratiksha. If bhakti that will manifest in somebody's heart, then mukti saram mukulitanjali, mukti devi, she'll fold his hand and always be ready to get any permission from the devotee. Please engage me in service of your Prabhu. I am ready to service. So mukti want to serve Bhagavan and want to help the devotee. And you have heard about the dialogue between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Srila Sarvam Bhattacharya. They are also mukti padesha dayabhar. He will be inheritant of mukti. Sarvabhar Bhattacharya could not tolerate this. Then he changed the verse and told bhakti padesha dayabhar. Mahaprabhu, no, because correct in Bhagavad. Bhagavad is beyond any error, no yata is needed there. In so many places, mukti is glorifying by in so many acharyas and Srimad Bhagavatam. So mukti devi is not a witch. So Jiva Goswami gave so many examples and Vallabha Acharya became speechless. When he came back, and Jiva Goswami came back to Rupa Goswami and told Rupa, who is this boy who was telling you? Then Rupa Goswami understood that Jiva Goswami makes some notorious thing with him. Must be any devet according to Shastra. Rupa Goswami humbly replied, my nephew and disciple. After some time, that old learned person went away from there. Then Rupa Goswami called, Jeev, you could not tolerate this old Brahman, could not give you proper respect. Rupa Goswami not asked anything to him. Rupa Goswami understood and told, you go to his side. Go his direction. This two meaning of his direction. His direction means go to your previous village. This is like Purvaksham. And Jiva Goswami took this east means his direction of Braj. So he went to Nandaghat Bhaygaon. And he lives in the hole of crocodile. Always weeping, Haru, Har Sanatan, please be merciful on me. And stop eating, drinking, everything. Day by day, he gets skinny, and so many itches come all over body. And Sanatana Goswami always move here and there in Braj, and he well known in whole Braj, Bada Baba. And all over Braj, they respect Sanatana Goswami so much. When Sanatana Goswami did his journey, arrived at the village, they told, oh Bada Baba, we have one Chota Baba also here in our village. He's so renounced. We never seen our whole life. Everyone is renounced than you also. Always only weeping, Haru, Haru Sanatan, please be merciful on me. Sometimes taking the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, sometimes taking the name of Divine Kapu, weeping and weeping only. Then Sanatana Goswami understood, this is not other than Jeev. Then Sadhan says, can you show me? Then they took Sanatana Goswami to Jiva Goswami. Sanatana Goswami brought him with him, and one day discussion was going on, Rupa Goswami was giving discussion. Then Sanatana Goswami asked, what is the duty of a Vaishnava towards living entity, means Jiva? Then Rupa Goswami told, be mercy towards living entity, means Jiva. Here Jiva means two meanings. Sanatana Goswami want to say, what is the duty of Vaishnava to this boy Jiva? And Rupa Goswami is telling for all Jiva. Then Sanatana Goswami told, Sanatana Goswami was elder brother and guru of Srila Rupa Goswami. Then Sanatana Goswami told, if the duty of a Vaishnava be merciful towards Jiva, why you not be merciful this Jiva? Then Sanatana Goswami brought Jiva and put him in the lap of Rupa Goswami. And both guru and sister began to weep bitterly. Rupa Goswami also was weeping and Jiva Goswami also was weeping. So here Jiva Goswami showed us that how Guru Nishtha was so strong in his heart, even he could not tolerate any kind of defame of his Gurudev. So we have to be strong enough, have to take instruction from Jiva Goswami, how to respect Gurudev, how to serve Gurudev. If anyone will defame our Gurudev, we shall cut their all arguments by our Shastriya Praman. If could not do so, have to keep our foot earplug and take bath in Ganga, Jamuna, Ocean with full cloth. And if you are so powerful, then like Hanuman, he who won the whole Lanka. For this reason, Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur told, Yato parihare jai pati ninda kare, tabe lati marata sire rupare. Hearing the glory of Nityananda Prabhu, even a sinner, yekadesai Nityananda Prabhu, I shall kick on his head. So we have to be so bold like Hanuman or Vrindavan Das Thakur. Whoever criticizes our Gurudev, we shall cut their all arguments. And
but if Gurudev should be very...
And Gurudev must be very bona fide, not so-called Gurudev. So now one inquiry may come in our mind. If Rupa Goswami is bona fide Gurudev, his second body of Mahaprabhu, and Jiva Goswami also eternal associate of Mahaprabhu and divine couple, there is no fault among between them. So if Jiva Goswami is correct, then other hand Rupa Goswami must be wrong. If Rupa Goswami is correct, then Jiva Goswami must be wrong. But wrong word is not in their dictionary, in their character. So how we can reconcile this? Srila Jiva Goswami, he acts like a disciple, and Rupa Goswami also acts like a Gurudev. What Rupa Goswami acted? He acted like a bona fide Gurudev. He was embodiment of humility, and Jiva Goswami was also very mature disciple, too much nishtha towards Gurudev, which he did, is also correct. So by this you have to reconcile. Another thing you shall listen from Gurudev's lotus feet, please. Hare Krishna. Pankara Lota 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 Lota
Lota. After that, something shaman. Other important thing, copy that.
First, I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my Paramaraja Tuma Guru Pada Padma, Nichalila Pravishta Om Vishnu Pada Stotarasita Sri Srimad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada, and the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my Paramaraja Tuma Guru Pada Padma, Om Vishnu Pad Astodhirasata Sri Srimad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, to all of our Guru Varga and all the assembled devotees. Sri Jiva Goswami was described very poetically and beautifully by Srila Gurudev in a Mathura lecture in 1992 on this same disappearance day anniversary. He said that Jiva Goswami established the integrity of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mood, which he gave to all fortunate jivas, of Parikya Bhav, of the gopis, which was later on taught by Sri Rupa Goswami. By taking the river, the ever-flowing river of Ras, of Radha and Krishna's pastimes, and blocking all sides, both sides of the river, with the very strong and powerful rocks of strong philosophical conclusions. In this way, he protected that river from the contamination of the water of misconceptions. Very beautifully put by our Srila Gurudev.
You understand this thing? What he told you?
Not everything.
You could not hear?
I didn't hear.
You realize what he told? Many of them, they could not understand.
So, Sri Sri Radha Krishna's pastimes are the highest conclusive truths and the ultimate goal of all jivas, all fortunate jivas. These pastimes of the Lord are misunderstood by our mundane vision, and especially unscrupulous personalities take advantage of our shortcomings and teach the misconceptions far and wide. Jiva Goswami established the purity of Radha Krishna's pastimes by strong philosophy, establishing how Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, how Radharani and the gopis are his own internal powers and potencies, shaktis. They are owned by him. So although it appeared that he was dancing with other persons' wives, actually all other persons' wives belong to Krishna, not the opposite. In order to help less intelligent people to come into Vaishnavism, who would otherwise misunderstand the paramour pastimes of Radha and Krishna and the gopis, Sri Jiva Goswami appeared to have established Swakiya Bhav, or Radha and Krishna as a married couple. Because if they would try to understand their paramour relationship, then they would do then, 500 years ago, what they're doing now. They would say that this is mundane, and they would also imitate them, where you find men dressed as women and having illicit relationships in the name of Parikya Bhav Sadhana, thinking that they'll get perfection, but actually they go to hell by lusty activities. Srila Gurudev explained in his Gurudev's biography that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was externally in a male form, but internally he was in the mood of a gopi. Whereas these personalities, they're externally dressed as a woman, as a gopi, but internally they have the male bhav, purusha bhav, of lusty feelings towards women, so by their activities they go to hell. Some people criticized Jiva Goswami and said that he was not following the principles of Sri Rupa Goswami, which is Parikya Bhav, which is established by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Srila Viswanath Chakrabarti Thakur, who is accepted by Acharyas as the incarnation of Rupa Goswami, came and protected the integrity and established the integrity of Sri Jiva Goswami's teachings. As Sri Padmanabha Maharaj mentioned, it's the duty of the disciple to defend the bona fide spiritual master against all offenses and all attacks of misconceptions. Gurudev said, if somebody says, because one disciple or several disciples were thinking that if we say something or write something to defend Gurudev against other people who are blaspheming him, misunderstanding him, saying bad things about him, that he's not actually in Guru Parampara, actually we should love all Vaishnavas no matter what they say about our Guru. We should all chant Hare Krishna and love each other and be humble more than a blade of grass. But Gurudev said, anyone who thinks like that, he said, if somebody says your Guru is engaged in sense gratification, what will you do, smile and show your teeth? If you yourself cannot defend your Guru, then if you don't support someone who's defending your Guru, then you're not my disciple. Rather, he said, anyone who doesn't fulfill the manubhishtya of his spiritual master and doesn't defend his Gurudev and proper Siddhanta, he's actually not a disciple, but he's a eunuch. Gurudev said that when someone said that the Rath Yatra established by his Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj, was not authorized to be done in Navadvip, Gurudev began writing a very strong articles against that offense to his Guru Maharaj. And then it created a great agitation on the other side, and they began writing articles. And these articles went on back and forth for a whole year, creating tremendous agitation. And Gurudev again did that against the Sahajis who were misunderstanding the Lord's mood, that is Krishna's mood, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mood, and the mood of his associates, because Gurudev wrote the book, Five Essential Essays, and distributed them freely. And Gurudev said again, that created a great tumultuous agitation. But this is the duty of the disciple to protect the integrity of the Guru Parampara. So Jiva Goswami, in order to bring in those who would misunderstand the Lord's pastimes, he, and only he could have brilliantly done that, established Swaki above in Radha Krishna mood, which is that they are a married couple, so that people could gradually have faith that yes, they're bona fide and gradually come into Vaishnavism. But Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur explains that actually Jiva Goswami is the perfect follower of Srila Rupa Goswami, because he's not really saying Swaki above. What does Swa mean? Swa means own. It means married, but it also means own, of his own. Radha and Gopis are Krishna's own internal potency. They're non-different from him. And Parakya, Para, they are Parashakti. Srimati Radhika is the embodiment of Parashakti, Krishna's supreme transcendental power, which, as Sri Jiva Goswami himself explains in Tattva Sandarbha, that by his own desire, Krishna's Parashakti, his supreme transcendental energy, manifests the absolute truth, that supreme Sri Krishna, in four features. She manifests his own swarup, Swayam Bhagavan, his own original form is Krishna, his tat by Bhava Rup, that is all of his expansions beginning from Sri Baladevji, all of his abodes, all of his associates, his Jiva Vivanamsa potency, us, the living entities, and also Pradhan, his material energies. So Srimati Radhika is Krishna's Parashakti, and so she is, her relationship is in Parakya. She's not any others. Para also means others, but she's not any other. She's Krishna's supreme potency, Krishna's own potency. And therefore, Srila Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur explains that really Srila Jiva Goswami is saying that Swaki above and Parvati above both exist harmoniously and beautifully in the Supreme Lord of Gokula in Goloka Vrindavan. There are many accusations of Sri Jiva Goswami against him, and our Srila Prabhupada, who is also his defender, explains some of these in his Chaitanya Charitamrita purport. That is another incident where Jiva Goswami defended Srila Rupa Goswami and Srila Sanatana Goswami was when some wandering big Vijay went to Rupa and Sanatana and said, I'm challenging you to a debate in philosophy, and if you're defeated by me, then you should sign a statement that I'll be able to show to everyone that I've defeated you. So rather than waste their time, because no one wants to waste their time in arguing with someone who won't accept good arguments and agree to be defeated if his opponent has better arguments, so rather than waste their time, they immediately sign the paper, yes, we are defeated by you. When Srila Jiva Goswami found out about this, he told that person, first you defeat the disciple, and then we'll see if you've actually defeated the master. So Jiva Goswami is accused of not being humble. But as Srila Gurudev just explained, it's the duty of the guru to be very humble, but it's the guru of the duty of the disciple to not tolerate any offense to his bona fide Gurudev. So actually, Jiva Goswami was being the perfect disciple by defending his Gurudev. And he wrote, he's known as the greatest scholar of his time, as Gurudev just mentioned. Despite, it's normal for bona fide acharyas to be accused of so many things. Like Srila Viswanath Chakrabarti Thakur, there was an attempted murder against him, murder of him, because when they threatened, when the, what do you call those Brahmins? Smarta Brahmins challenged him that if you don't stop preaching Radha Nuga Bhakti, then we're going to have to do something. So he didn't stop, and so they tried to murder him. They found him, they looked for him and searched everywhere where he was doing his bhajan in Vrindavan, very early in the Brahma Muhurta time of the morning. And they thought that they saw him entering into some kunj. So they went in there and they didn't see him anymore, but they saw a very young, beautiful Kishori girl, teenager, 12 and a half years old. And they asked, she was just picking flowers, and they asked, have you seen a sadhu around? And she said, yes, I saw him for some time, but then I think he went in that direction. So they went in that direction, but then they looked back towards the beautiful Kishori, and they saw that she was actually Viswanath Chakrabarti Thakur. So they immediately surrendered to him and became his disciples and preached on his behalf. So the next acharyas are always defending the previous acharyas. So Srila Jiva Goswami also was accused, and he was accused that Sri Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, the author of Chaitanya Charitamrita, showed his unpublished manuscript to Jiva Goswami, and Jiva Goswami became very furious that, oh, now he will be known as a greater scholar than myself. So he took his Chaitanya Charitamrita manuscript and threw it in a well. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami became so shocked that he immediately died, but some man named Mukunda had an extra copy, and that's how it got published. So it's normal that the acharyas, the great acharyas, will be accused of so many things. Why? Because bhakti is not easy. It's very, very difficult and rare to come to bhakti. So the pure devotees, the acharyas, are...
This is false allegation.
Yes, our Prabhupada is saying this is a false allegation.
So no need of...
So my only point was that our Srila Prabhupada was saying how this is a false allegation.
We are very hankering of making so many disciples. Oh, disciples. Even by spending so much money, making so many dalal.
Agents.
That if you bring 5 disciples, I will pay so much. Nowadays going more. But you go coming, or any of the Goswami, 6 Goswami, Krishna Das Goswami. How many disciples? Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Srila Sanatana Goswami, Rup Goswami, Raghunath Bhatta. Srila Raghunath Goswami has no disciples at all. But whole world is the disciple. Shamananda, Prabhu came, but he was initiated by any guru. But Narottam Thakur and Srinivas were not initiated by anyone. They came in the shelter of Jiva Goswami. Jiva Goswami taught them all the Shastra, Ved, Upanishad, Shastra, everything. All the thoughts. They wanted to be initiated by Jiva Goswami, but Jiva Goswami refused and told that, oh, there are so many elevated Vaishnav more than me. Oh, please, you should go to
Lokanatha
Goswami. And you should go to
Gopal
Goswami. Why? They were not intended to go to them. They wanted that you are my guru. And they have accepted him. But yet, they followed the instructions of Jiva Goswami. Then Narottam Thakur went to
Loknath
Prabhu. And went to Gopal Prabhu. You see that, oh, Loknath Goswami, he refused to give initiation. But for so many years perhaps he waited and he even cleared the stool of Goswami in night. Then Loknath Goswami was bound to give him Similarly, Gopal Bhatta never met any disciple. But, by the request of Srila Jiva Goswami, he accepted only one disciple, like and they two and three, they went to Bengal and collected thousands and thousands of. Why? In the same way, like Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami and his Gurudev. His Gurudev was he never accepted any disciple. Only by the special request of Srila Bhakti Goswami. And he saw his also heart that if I am not initiating, they will die. So he was bound to give initiation, bound. Guru was fine, and he gave initiation, but accept him, no initiation to anyone. And is that disciple, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, what he did, miracle,
Bengal, whole India, and after that, whole world. But who is more merciful, guru or disciple? That disciples are more merciful than guru. Why? We see, for us I am telling, not for others. You know that Sri Loknath Goswami told to Narottam, oh, you are not qualified, you should go. At once to go. Relax. I don't lie. A disciple like you, we have no faith in Krishna name. Krishna name is himself. He has manifested his all power, all beauty, all appearances in his name. Name is more powerful than Krishna himself. So you have not faith in this. If you are doing bhajan, and if a person is coming thirsty and he wants water, he wanted water from Guru Loknath and he was chanting. Oh, he was upset. But when he went to Narottam Thakur, oh boy, baby sadhu, oh he took some water and gave. And then Loknath said, all you should return back to your home. Always doing this. Then he was so a strong personality that he went, but he followed his guru instruction. And he did thousands and thousands of disciples. So who is merciful in our I think that Narottam Thakur is more merciful. Though Loknath Goswami is also Manjari, Narottam Thakur is also Manjari. But it seems, oh, he is more merciful, that he has mercy for all. Oh. But in some way we can see that Loknath Goswami so there are so many things. If the Goswami had not made Shasti, Satsandar, six Sandar, if he had not written Gopalachan, if he had not explained commentaries of Udvalyan Bhakti Goswami Sindhu and so many books, he could not have known Goswami. So today we are offering our obeisances with the lotus of Jiva Goswami. That we should serve our Gurudev like him, we serve Guru Goswami. And in many aspects, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna, both, but very rare to be like him. But he should sprinkle his mercy. That we should, we can glorify Srila Jiva Goswami. I wanted to discuss something about bhajan, rahasya, written by Srila Bhaktivinoda. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is called what Manjari? Kamala Manjari. How he used to do bhajan? At the time of he was magistrate officer. In daytime in court, after court he had to write his judgments. So many books he wrote in night, taking something very light and sleeping at about 9 and 10. Woke up in the early or at 12 or 1. And do so many things. Bhajan, as a gopi, Arkiya gopi, always remembering Ashtakaliya Leela, totally observed in that. And in the morning again, writing judgments and and at that time he has written so many, more than 100 books, in so many languages, even in English. So, Jaiva Dharma Granta is higher in the tattva, but I consider myself, O Bhajan Rahasyam Bhūtu, very good. Favorable for us, he has written for us. This is the praise of God. So I began eating where? Put Jagannath Puri or
Vrindavan.
Only I finished 2 chapters, but not fully, but I finished. And that all, he divided our bhajan in 8 classes. Like Krishna, pastimes are divided into 8 parts. Ashtakaliya Leela. Similarly, he divided our bhajan into 8 parts. Morning, Nishanta. What is Nishanta?
End of night.
End of night. From morning. Then Purvanaha. And then midday. Then Purvanna. 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 And then Sayanna. And then evening, and then midnight, 8 parts. Our bhajan is like that. First part of our bhajan is what? Sadhu Sangha. Yes, so, Shraddha in Sadhu Sangha. How Shraddha begins? In Sadhu Sangha. That will explain that we, who are we are eternal servants of the Krishna. And you must serve Krishna. You must chant. Don't have any worldly desire. Don't engage yourself in worldly sense gratification. Krishna is very powerful. He has invested his all power in his
holy name,
Sravanam, Kirtanam, in all
nine
of 64 kinds of them. All are very powerful. You will be happy. You cannot be happy by collecting so many things for your sense gratification. Especially money. It can. Oh, money will give you danger in life. So don't go. Money cannot give you happiness. And so many things in your life. If you have money, anyhow you can make it favorable for bhakti. But don't want money. If money goes, then pray to Krishna that, oh, you are very merciful that is everything you have taken and made me. Like this. And then, oh, like Srivas Pandit says some bhajira and Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. If he did like, man, Mahaprabhu, what you are doing? You are doing nothing. How you will maintain your life and your family life? Then he told you, man, what is this? 1, 2, 3? Then he told, we are chanting and doing kirtan. All brothers, 4 brothers, no marriage. 4 brothers were. Then, we are family. So, if not, we cannot do any maintenance, we will fast for 1 day. And then, second also. Second day we will walk. And third day also. But if fourth day no, nothing, we will jump in. Mahaprabhu told, oh, Lakshmi can take anything.
Lakshmi, goddess of fortune.
But you will have not to be. I will bring, carry all the paraphernalia for you, personally. And he did. So we should also know the object of life is happiness. But what kind of happiness? By serving Krishna. By practicing bhakti yoga. And if you are not doing, you are nonsense. Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami, oh, Rashtra. I cannot tell like you. But you can think what he told, that I am Rashtra. Always engaged in money. Vaishnava has come to your house from India, and you have no time at all to hear. What is it? I will not tell. So, by all Harikatha, at once he has a strong belief and gives some suffering. And this is called Sarada. I have explained all this. But you should remember one thing. If Shraddha is there, you have it. And Shraddha is really in your heart. But no sadhu sang, then what will you be? The Shraddha will go very soon because you are not so strong. When you will come in our state, even sannyas will not save you. Sannyas will
renounce our.
It will not. So many sannyasis have fallen. But anyone coming in our stage, then bhakti name. Like Haridas Thakur, what he told, if anyone will kill us, murder me, even I will not stop chanting. Now, that so many are asking. They have taken diksha also, second initiation. And they are asking, Gurudev, I have so many problems. I have no money. Should I stop
chanting
and serving deities? And what to do? I cannot maintain. Please allow me not to chant and not to serve deities and everything. I replied, Oh, I cannot. I cannot.
Approve this.
I can.
Allow it.
Allow. Never, never. You should join, but I cannot. Allow you to stop chanting and even one round you should go on doing. Even if not mala, but you should do. You should serve the deities that you are serving. Go on. But I will not allow. So, we have discussed all these things. I wanted to discuss. So we will discuss something. Today is perhaps a drama play. After that, have a Christmas, good Christmas. And drama play, you should. Apple is ready and fine. Long Prema.